Welcome to Cinemeric Live, our video series that aims to present individual topics on application technology in short, simple, comprehensible movies that don't take up too much of your time. Today's topic, dynamic 5-axis machining programmed directly on the control. We'll start by going over the basics of multi-axis, multi-face milling machining again. This will be followed by an explanation of 5-axis transformation. The tool orientation and the 3D radius compensation are repeated, and of course an example workpiece is milled live on the machine, which will be the central part of today's presentation. As always, the presentation is rounded off with a summary of what we've learned today. We start by comparing 3+2 machining with 5-axis milling. What the two manufacturing methods have in common is that they both have three linear axes, X, Y, and Z. And both methods also have two rotary axes, A, B, or C. The difference between 3+2 and 5-axis machining is static orientation of the tool in 3+2 and dynamic orientation of the tool in 5-axis simultaneous machining. So, when is which used? 3+2 axis machining is mainly used for roughing and preliminary finishing of 3D contours. Here you can see the static orientation of the tool while machining oblique lines. For parts of this type, the focus is on economic efficiency. Most parts and components can be produced with 3+2 axes. For more information, see our video Multi-Face Machining Milling 3+2 Axes, in which this topic has been dealt with in detail. This method is primarily used in tool and mold making. In dynamic 5-axis machining, in simultaneous machining, the aim is final machining for finishing. That is, we can achieve very good surface qualities. This type of machining is, of course, ideal for machining components with large cavities and frequent changes in curvature. Freeform surfaces for mold making, and of course, turbine and aircraft engine components, and generally structural components in the airplane. Let's move on to the mechanical design of milling machines. There are three constellations, that is, three possible basic kinematic designs for the movement of milling machines. The first is head-head kinematics. Here, all movements of the machine are performed in the head. The table remains completely immobile throughout. The second is not head-head, but table-table kinematics. In this case, the head is completely immobile and all movements are performed in the table only. The third possibility is mixed kinematics. This means both the head of the machine and the table execute movements at the same time and are synchronized so that all 5-axis movements can be achieved with this head-table variant. Dynamic 5-axis machining is possible in all these constellations, whichever type of kinematics you have on your machine. Today, in our practical example, we're using table-table kinematics. Here is a short example to illustrate the topic of movements, i.e. kinematics of the machine. In head-head kinematics, the tool moves around the workpiece. The workpiece is immobile. In table-table kinematics, the tool is immobile and the workpiece moves in the axes. So, what does this tell us? Completely different machine movements produce the same result. And the movement of the tool tip and the tool orientation are always identical relative to the workpiece surface. Five-axis transformation is the term used for when the linear and rotary axes move simultaneously. Executing these linear and rotary axis movements with a clamp tool produces a particular mechanical effect. The movement is curved. This can also be seen clearly here. This is the effect that arises when linear and rotary axes are engaged simultaneously. How can this effect be avoided in simultaneous five-axis machining? The solution is Traore. The Traore command groups these calculations together. Traore consists of two words, transformation and orientation. The effect is that the tool tip remains immobile in space during machining. This is achieved by an additional compensating movement in the Z-axis during the linear and rotary axis movements. This results in a straight line. To put it another way, Traore enables convenient programming of the tool tip, the actual point of contact with the workpiece, completely independently of the mechanical design of the machine. The five-axis transformation is activated by the Traore command at the appropriate point in the NC program. And from that point on, all position data always refer to the tip of the tool. All axes are interpolated simultaneously, resulting in NC programs that are independent of the kinematics and tool. The Traore command is deactivated, along with five-axis transformation, with the Trafo-off command at the appropriate point at the end of the NC program. After the five-axis transformation by the Traore command has been activated, there are various ways of orienting the tool, i.e. for machining. One of these is the command ORIAXES. ORIAXES is the command for linear interpolation, also called standard interpolation. And the ORIAXES command is used when it's not necessary for the tool to move along a precisely defined surface. A further command is the command ORIVECT. ORIVECT is the command for vector interpolation, and it's frequently used for milling pockets with usually flat and inclined walls. One important function in the control is correction of the tool radius. During 2.5D milling, it's important to tell the control whether the tool is to traverse the tool path right or left of the contour. The second important feature of a cutter radius compensation is the nominal size of the cutter, that is 12 mm in this case, and the actual dimension, which also changes due to wear or regrinding, with which this difference is compensated, i.e. corrected. In 3D milling, the cutter radius is also corrected. In this case, the tool orientation has to be changed continuously, as does the direction of compensation too, of course. This is implemented as follows. First, this five-axis transformation is activated with the Traore command. Then, 3D cutter radius compensation is activated with the commands CUT3DC and CUT3DF. And it looks like this. Compensation is effected in the circumference of the milling tool with the command CUT3DC. The direction of compensation is always perpendicular to the plane on which the cutter is moving. For face milling, we use the command CUT3DF. This is somewhat more complex because the cutter has to be constantly compensated and recalculated at each individual point of its radius. This results in a continuous offset. The tool orientation is relative to the workpiece surface. Here in our practical section, we see our example part on the machine, which, as was mentioned before, has table kinematics. After face milling and rough milling of the pocket, the first thing we do is mill the outer edge with Orivect in accordance with the set angle with the oriented tool. This is done as follows. Here we see our main program, programmed in Shop Mill for the first time. And this is where the subprogram is called each time, in this case, hobbing the upper edge. And here too, as we mentioned in the theoretical section, the call for 5-axis transformation with the Traori command. In the block after next, Orivect to call vector programming, immediately followed by Cut3DC for cutter radius compensation in the circumference of the milling cutter. When the operation is completed, here is the trafo off call again to deactivate 5-axis transformation. This is all performed analogously for the pocket edge. That's this operation here. This is machined with Ori axes. Same call, Traori, Ori axes, and here again, cut 3DF, this time cutter radius compensation on the face of the milling cutter. And at the end, our trafo off once again to reset the setting and deactivate 5-axis transformation. After these milling operations, we mill the hemisphere simultaneously with 5 axes, with an oriented B axis and simultaneous line-by-line milling, always with the optimum milling angle with respect to the sphere, and with a ball cutter, that is, a ball nose end mill. Here too, the program sequence looks like this. After entry of the necessary parameters, Traori is called. Here again, Orivect for vector programming and the corresponding parameters for 3D finishing and roughing machining. And at the end again, with our deactivation of the transformation and resetting of the axes. Close the program, return to the start of the program, and run it with cycle start. To recap, Traori enables convenient programming of the tooltip independently of the kinematics of the machine. Ori axes is the command for linear interpolation. Orivect, the command for vector interpolation of the tool orientation. The 3D cutter radius compensation takes the changing movement of the tool orientation into account. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.